So for GAE Java, there are detailed documentation for low-level data store API. However, fewer and incomplete documentation for how to map entity relationships with JDO JPA. Data nucleus is detailed, however, no way, easy way to tell if GAE supports the feature. So there's a question there somewhere.
Yeah, so the question is really, I think, around the, you know, getting to the full details and capabilities of JDO and JPA on App Engine. Right. Maybe I should put this a little bit in context. When we launched the Java runtime on App Engine, you know, we looked at kind of the active frameworks and abstractions that people were using. JDO and JPA were very popular, and so we did a lot of work to make sure that, you know, those were properly supported in App Engine. We also felt like users really benefited from SQL-like language, and so we launched GQL as a kind of a way of accessing the data store. And what we found over time, actually, is that developers, after a little while, feel much more productive when they're kind of working much closer with kind of the low-level APIs of App Engine or some abstraction that sits on top of those low-level APIs. So in the case of Python, we had the low-level Python data store. We've now iterated on that, and we have NDB, the new database model, which is sort of the way that we wish we had written it the first time, with Memcache built in and you know, a lot, just usability is a lot better. On the Java side, we've actually had the community step up and produce an ORM framework called Objectify. Okay. And there's others out there. There's a developer in Japan who created something called Slim 3. It's another abstraction layer for Java. And they do a really good job of sort of abstracting the way of the data store a little bit, but still staying very close to kind of the native performance characteristics, doing things kind of the right way. Objectify, I know, also has Memcache built in. And it just lets you work with POJO, so plain old Java objects. So you have a Java object with a bunch of properties, getters and setters. You can just take that object, you can push it in the data store, get it right back out. And that's really, that feels a lot more natural working in App Engine than the JDO and JPA. And so the way to kind of look at those technologies right now is, if you're a big JDO, JPA fan, or you just use those in your environment and you'd like to, please continue to use them. They're there for you. Yeah. But if you're kind of new to App Engine or you're at all unfamiliar about JDO and JPA, by all means, use either the low-level APIs or something like Objectify in Java, because you'll just have a much better experience. And those were written, you know, from the ground up for App Engine. Whereas JDO and JPA were written in a world where, you know, SQL was king. Yeah. And they just, it's a little bit of an unnatural fit. We got that square peg into the round hole, but you know, we had to use a hammer a little bit, and so the corners are a little bit rounded off.
Okay, I come from a Java EE background, so I used to have a very big hammer.